Hello dear viewer, my name is Inderpreet Singh from the Software and Testing Training channel. This week I ran a search on software testing jobs and I found a common responsibility is regarding the test cases. The person needs to identify and document test cases, design test scenarios, write test cases, translate requirements into test cases, design and execute test cases, create and maintain test cases, etc. If you need to prepare for interview questions on test cases or need test cases in manual testing or test cases in software testing for your project, these test cases are available in a web application. You can simply search and copy or download the test cases as CSV file, XLS file or PDF file. And in this web application, you can find that there are test cases for login page, test cases for Amazon website or any e-commerce website, test cases for registration page, test cases for mobile, API testing, payment, single sign-on, and more functionalities. The name of the web application is TestCaseHub. It is a test case repository or test scenario repository, meaning a test case container or a test scenario container. TestCaseHub is totally free to use. The test cases are at a high level, written in a few words, and organized by functionality or feature. They are also logical test cases or test scenarios, and you can give your own steps and your own test data in order to actually use them as physical test cases in your project. The test cases have been contributed by the software testing community, meaning the QA professionals working in different organizations have contributed these test cases and test scenarios. Once a contributor submits his or her test cases, they are added to TestCaseHub only after review. This is the TestCaseHub on the TestCaseHub.net website. I will put this website link at the bottom of the description also. Now here there is the search box and there is buttons to search or add test cases if you are a contributor. If you find that some test cases are missing, you can request the functionality. Here are some metrics. There is 1500 plus test cases, and out of which 1000 plus test cases have been published, and there are 288 requested test cases. Now let us say that I want to find out what are the different test cases or test scenarios for testing the login functionality, because I want to prepare for an interview or I need to test the login functionality in my own application, in my own product. Just click on the search box and here I can type login, and here you can see that there is an autocomplete, so I can select any of these terms here. It is showing all the test cases for the login functionality. Now about this table, here there is the test case number, then this is the actual test case. Here it is mentioned whether it is a positive test, meaning it should return in success, or it is a negative test, meaning it should return in an error message. Then the priority can be P1 as the highest priority, P2, P3 and P4 is the lowest priority. And this is column for the author. And here it is possible to vote for the test case. So there is an upvote and there is a downvote. But you can only do that if you sign up and then log in. And it is showing 10 entries here. For example, the very first test case is that test with null values. And the second test case is swipe the ID password and test that it should not log in. So it is showing 10 test cases here. and there are a total of 29 entries. I can go to the next page and it is showing other test cases. Sign in and refresh the page. It shouldn't ask to sign in again. Or I can select that it can show 25 or 100 or all the entries. Then I can see all the test cases and read them at one time. In TestCase Hub, if I'm searching only for the login test cases, then there are different search terms that I can use. And here I've done a partial mapping. For testing the login page, I can search for login, sign in, forgot password, logout, and password. So this will give me more test cases that I can have for the login page. Similarly, for Amazon website, I can look for search functionality, search page, add to cart, breadcrumbs, navigation, discount coupon, offer, payment. For testing registration page, I can search for create your account, register and sign up functionalities on TestCase Hub. For API testing, I can search for API and API testing functionalities in TestCase Hub. Now in TestCase Hub, I have already searched with login functionality. I can search with sign in also. And it will show me test cases for sign in. For example, username is missing, or test with numeric value, or I can search for forgot password. This is also a part of the login functionality. And there are all these test cases for the forgot password. And similarly, I can search for logout and just password also. Now let me go back to the home page of TestCase Hub. Now suppose you want to search test cases for e-commerce website like Amazon. So as I showed you in the partial mapping, you can find the test cases for search, search page, add to cart, etc. If it is a large system with many functionalities, I find it useful to navigate to all available scenarios here. So I'm going to click on all available scenarios. I can see that add to cart, breadcrumbs, navigation, even dashboard. I can look at all these functionalities. Now, for instance, let me select this search, because search is a very important functionality on an e-commerce website like Amazon. So there should be test case for pagination, meaning dividing up the search results into different pages. If it is an invalid search query, this is a negative test case. Then partial search, just giving the part of the search term, etc. And you can see in the priority column, the test cases with the highest priority are at the top. Now let me go back to the home page. Now if I want test cases for registration page, so let me again go to all available scenarios. And here for registration, I can search create your account. And there are test cases for verify the functionality of first name, verify the functionality of email address, etc. And in the search results, you will see that priority P1 test cases are at the top. And if there are multiple P1 priority test cases, so the one with the more upvotes is going to be at the top. Again, let me go back. And now for test cases for registration page, I can also go and look at register. So there are more test cases here. Register on portal using only mandatory fields, a positive test case. Register an existing username or email which is already registered. This is a negative test case. It should result in an error. And similarly, I can search for the sign up functionality also. Let us say that I am going to test the mobile application, and so I can look in all available scenarios for mobile app accessibility. And in the search results, it's going to show 39 because that is the number it showed over there. So let me look at all the entries. And here there are 39 test cases here. I've seen all the P1 test cases. I just want to see what are the P2 test cases. I can use this priority filter, and now it is showing me only the P2 priority test cases here. And for the newer test cases that have been contributed by the contributors, there are tags also available. So these tags will work for the test cases, and I can select only for mobile or only for Android, only for iOS also. If I want to do API testing, then there are test cases. I can search for API or go to all available scenarios and select the API functionality. For example, verify the correct HTTP status code, the verify response payload, etc. SSO stands for single sign-on, so there are 10 test cases for that. So in SSO, for user interface testing, user should be able to do SSO login using valid username and password. So this is a positive test case. And here there are positive test cases and negative test cases. If I only want to see the positive test cases, I can uncheck negative, and now it is going to show only the positive test cases. If you find that some test cases are missing, so you can request the functionality. It says that login to add test cases or request functionality. So you can click on the sign up form here. Enter your name, email address, LinkedIn profile link, and confirm password, and click on sign up. It will send you a verification email. Once you click on the link given in that email, then you will be able to log in. I signed up to TestCaseHub and I am logged into TestCaseHub now. So now if I click on request functionality, it will ask me enter your functionality name here, and I can get the test cases from the software testing community. Suppose I'm searching for some test cases. So let's say test cases for payment. Here I can upvote and increase the number of votes also, because I'm signed in now. Let me go to the home page. Because I'm signed in, I can add test cases. And here I have to give the functionality name, for what functionality I'm entering the test case, and then enter your test case here. In fact, today I added a few test cases, and I can show them to you in the profile. So these are the test cases I added for the payment functionality. For example, verify that no amount is debited if the amount of the transaction exceeds the account balance, etc. When adding test cases as a contributor, you can click on the plus button to add more test cases, or if you have a bunch of test cases, so you can also upload bulk test cases. I hope that you use TestCaseHub for your software testing interview preparation. Also use TestCaseHub to get all available scenarios for better software testing in your project. Thank you, and see you in my next tutorial.